Since 1991, ProTaper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, ProTaper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more. Everyone, welcome to the Kickstart Podcast presented by ProTaper. We have a full house here in the Swapmoto Live offices as Anton's in town. ARay is back from Poundtown, USA. And it is the Monday after the Fox Raceway 2 National, and our motocross season is officially over. And man, I think we're all still dehydrated, right, guys?
Yep.
It was hot.
Sure.
I could tell Sunday morning.
It was like crazy hot. There was some spots of the place where they had a nice breeze and it wasn't too bad, but whenever it was like static hot, like right there in the pits where there was no wind blow, you're like, yeah, it's hot.
Dude, first practice on Saturday morning, I walked out and I got right next to that first tabletop that everybody always jumps, and I just started just gushing sweat. And yep. I was like, oh no, this is going to be bad. But then it got better after that.
I mean, it was 8:30 and it was already 90 degrees.
And humid.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm like, what
is going on? It's like 40% humidity. It's crazy.
Yeah. Well, they had like some rain in like Lake Elsinore and then a little bit in the hills there on Friday. But yeah, I mean, the track looked gnarly, and they made it slower too, so that had to make it even hotter for the riders, right? Because there was less wind. They weren't going as fast. There was a lot of slow sections, but jeez.
I think I drank 12 bottles of water before I peed.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, wow. I only peed twice all day.
Yeah, same.
It was bad. But you know what? So they shortened the motos by 5 minutes, right? All the riders said they couldn't tell it was shortened.
Well, I mean, the lap time was 2 minutes, 30 seconds. So
it was two laps.
Yeah, I mean, two it was laps still left. Another 5 minutes but added to
everyone
it.
Everyone said that they are grateful for the extra 30 minutes between motos, though.
Yeah. I think that was nice for some of the riders to be able to recover a little bit better. You know,
I think it's better for everything, too, because it gives us everybody a chance to reset, because that break between last lap of 450 Moto 1, and they're already in staging for 250 Moto 2. You have no time.
Yeah.
And then it gave that TV thing a good chance to hype it back up one more time.
Yep.
Like, even as a racer during outdoors, like the regular schedule, you come off the track, you're dead first moto, right? You come back to the truck, you strip down all of your gear, you sit there for about 5 minutes, cool down, whether you have like an ice bath or not, get some water, try to get some food down. And by that time, it's like, shit, I have 10 minutes before first call. You know, like, you have no time. You're having to get your gear back on, you know, like, shoving food down your throat, and then the bell goes off, and you're like, shit, like, I have no time. So, the riders, I think, helped with that a little bit. Like, I think that was a good call for everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, the coolest thing I saw, well, not the coolest thing, but one thing I saw, I was like, oh, that's rad. I was jealous, is after the first moto, that little tent behind the podium, Eli rips his boots off. Everyone's pouring water on everybody, right? But he had an ice chest full of ice water, and he shoved his feet in the ice chest.
Oh, nice.
That had to feel so good because your body heat escapes through your head and your feet.
Yeah, yep.
But, I was standing there. I was like, God, I wish I could put my feet in.
That's got to feel so good after a moto, like 30 minutes when it's that hot. Everyone's just pouring water down on you. Like,
Even when he came in after that first moto and how fast he was trying to get his helmet off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like getting his gloves off, giving him to Coker, and then just getting done. You could tell, like, whoa, dude, he had done everything. But if you watch it again, look how many times he looks over at Chase to see how Chase is doing, too.
Yep.
Even they sat down and he, like, takes a glance over and you're like, oh, it's on. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, man. Now, I'll be the first to say that I was wrong.
Yep.
Dude. Like, I was pulling for Sexton. Like, Sexton was my guy the whole weekend. Like, I'm like, he's going to do it. He's going to do it. You know, like, I even went back to last year. I looked at – or not last year, but the first race. Chase beat him by 30-something seconds. I'm like, how is he going to find a setting and be 40 seconds faster than Chase? You know, I just thought that Chase had it, you know, both motos.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, I mean, Eli's back was against the wall, and he's like, man, he said it. I'm not a fan of this track, and, you know, his bike, he said at the beginning, like, they weren't there yet with it. But I guess he did come to California a bit early and test there. He got some stuff figured out, and it worked. I mean, shit. I mean, he was the better guy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. When he, at the end of that first moto, when he just reeled it in, I was like, damn.
And he was charging so hard. I was in the manager's tower watching, and you could barely hear Chase's bike.
You have the whole year, right?
Yeah. Just, and then Eli's just like wide open around the whole track, just hanging on for dear life, legs flying everywhere. I'm like, he is going for it.
It's harder to say what was more impressive, like funner to watch, how he would blast out of these flat corners where they're super ripped and nice and chocolate cake and just rot, or how fast he would charge down the hills.
Dude.
Even the big triple step over, the very last lap, you got to think it's his last ever pro motocross national. He landed on the top side of it and then just all the way down. And I took a photo. I was like, that was so sick. I'm so glad I got to see how gnarly he pushed to the very end.
Yeah,
I think it was good for him, too, like at a track that he's never been really that good at.
Mm-hmm.
At his last outdoor national that we're probably going to see him at, because he's going to be Supercross only next year, just to go 1-1 and to win the championship coming in down to the last moto, I feel like that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
it had to be his most exciting, most stressful championship of his career, right? 100%.
But at the same time, I feel like this year he's been in the best mood that he's had. You know, switching over to Yamaha, he's just been happier this year, right? So I think it's just a nice wind down for him, like a good. Mm-hmm. It was a great year.
If there was ever a question of, like, has he sorted out all the issues? Like, all the little mistakes that you got to think how many times in the Dungy Supercross years? He did the same things that Chase did all day on Saturday, you know? Yeah. So you know that he's over it. You know Chase will get over it eventually, too.
Yeah.
But it's funny to hear with Eli, because, you know, we keep hearing last national. Monster really wants him to come back.
Yeah.
And it just pretty much sounds like it'll take a blank check, but I don't think that he's still going to do it.
He told me, he's all, dude, they are knocking on my door right now hard. And I go, okay. And he goes, but it's 90% no, 10% yes.
Yeah.
And then we talked some more, and then he goes, wait. It's 95%.
Even Mitch Covington was talking to Kathy, and like, he's got two more in him. He's got two more out here with him. And she's like, are you serious?
Yeah.
But yeah, I got to talk with him after the race, and I was like, dude, so gnarly. Everyone was saying, Chase's track, you know, Chase got this. I go, did that fire you up? And he goes, oh yeah. He goes, but more, it was the old veteran with championship experience drawing on that and the rookie folding.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But even more so, like, especially this round, if you look at this track versus the first round suited Eli way more than this round. Like, this round, with how technical and rutted it was, you'd think, like I saw the prep and I was like, even more so, like, oh, Sexton's taking it today.
Mm-hmm. You know, you'd said something when we were up there for that first moto. Was that me? And you could just see he had the sunglasses on, he had the vest, and just 1,000-yard stare.
Terminator.
And you nudge me, and you're like, he's all business right now. And I'm like, oh, yeah.
Crazy.
Dude, he wasn't even, like, stone-faced. He was frowning.
Yeah.
Like.
Didn't blink anything. Yeah. Just had it on.
Well, you couldn't tell if he's blinking or not behind the iridium lenses.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he was – didn't talk to anyone.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then how nervous did Jelly look on the
a little
too. But
that couldn't have been a better way too. Even as I stood right at the second turn, and it was unfortunate to watch like 95% of the factory go down. But you're just like, yes, like, so this is everybody now. And then to hear James go, "Thank you, God," on television, I was dying, because I know that was from Rush Hour.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so I didn't watch the broadcast yet, but Malcolm? No, Plessinger said Dungy caused it.
Yep. He knifes the front, and then him and Christian go together, and then everything goes on.
Yeah. But, I mean, how fortunate was that? I mean, we got the start that we all wanted, right, in that moto, like first and second, boom, and then everyone else crashes. But it was like when that happened, I was like, oh, I guess Jason's not getting in between, and we're not even going to have the opportunity to. And then you saw who was in third, fourth, fifth early on, and you're like,
it's on.
Yep.
Yeah, they're checking out.
Yep.
They were like that all day, too. First lap of the first practice, they went out straight together. Chase took the inside line through the first turn. Eli went and ripped the outside. And then to see him do it again in the first moto, it was all day. It was like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And props to Yamaha, too, right? Like, because with Eli in the past, I mean, they've had bike issues, you know. Eli and Cowie, where, you know, you would always see the thing smoking, everything. That bike all year.
Rock solid, right?
Yeah, rock solid. All Yamaha, it was not a puff of smoke out of that thing all
year. Okay, wait. Remember back in the day when all you ever heard about was fuel boiling.
Right.
Yeah.
No one said that to me on Sunday.
Really?
And wouldn't you think shit would boil when it's 100?
Well, I know Honda's been struggling all year, right? Mm. Or Hondas, I should say.
Hondas, especially the privateer
ones. And they've had bigger tanks, yeah.
I think that has to do with the aluminum tank because it's going to be hotter, right?
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah, you would think that an aluminum tank, it would like boil quicker because it's kind of like a skillet.
I was thinking the same thing, though, because just talking to a couple of the riders and mechanics, like the last 2 weeks, the guys out in SoCal, I should say, the last 2 weeks, they've been struggling boiling fuel like during the practice days, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I was kind of surprised, too.
Yeah, I mean, no one in Howard's weekend said their bike boiled over.
But
or anything.
The track was a lot tighter, so maybe they weren't as
wide open.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Ripping, you know? Yeah.
But then that's also less airflow through the radiator, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Eli's right radiator had a fan, like the KTM-style battery fan.
Nice.
Okay. Yeah, which was the first. I hadn't seen that all year, and I'd been looking. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I remember they used to run the fans whenever I rode the factory Yamaha, but I'd never seen it on the star bike, right?
I hadn't seen it this year until really, yeah. I think, this weekend, yeah. Mm. But they had never run the electric water pump. 450 didn't need it.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Wow. Okay. Chase?
Hmm.
I loved Eli's kit.
Oh, dude. So when the Alpine Stars guy hit me up last week and was like, hey, we're doing the launch next week. I'm going to send you a kit. What are your sizes, blah, blah. I was like, cross my fingers. I'm like, oh, I hope it's that kit.
It was the green?
Yeah. It wow. wasn't, though. But that kit is sick, yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of surprised to see Eli in green. Especially like on a championship weekend and Yamaha's so...
I think,
is it green and blue?
Well, yeah, the back was green, but the front had a lot of blue and white in it.
Okay.
Yeah. Looked good, though.
Maybe? Yeah, I don't know. It looked good. I thought it was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how it is. I've been thinking this like all week. A company like Alpine Stars, company like Oakley, where you have both of your guys in contention.
Right?
I mean, Alpine Stars already knows they're going to win both titles, but as it was to see that. To have both your guys there, and that's just got to be so big for two brands. That post that Alpine Stars did too, thinking like,
yeah,
just thanks for the year.
Badass.
That was cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alpine Stars crushed it this year with Jett, Chase, and Eli. I mean, mm-hmm. Shit. I mean,
they just, Tom Vial.
Yeah, Tom Vial. I mean, they swept it.
Yep.
I mean, it was Supercross too. Oh my God.
Even Craig, boots and helmet. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Who's third? I was so concentrated on that.
Jason,
dude, how about his comeback in the first moto?
Ripping.
He's good. He's good at that,
so
right?
Good.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Even a couple times in that last moto, you could tell how much he was like, I'm just not going to lay over. Even though he told you, like, I don't want to be the guy to get in the way.
Yeah, but see, the thing is he was ahead of both of them.
Uh-huh.
Right? So.
But he didn't lay up. That back section before they went to the hills, where it was pretty much just stop and go. And if you had the inside line, you could totally block the guy out and mess him up. And he held strong because Eli tried it on him, and he just fought right back. And you saw nobody do that there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what do you guys think? Chase's crash while he's ahead of Eli? Front end tuck?
He had a bump, it looked like.
Yeah, I mean, like they said on the broadcast that Chase might have like looked over for like a glance, because coming out of that corner, you see the guys dropping down right there, like on the left. Mm-hmm. I think he might have been like looking at where Eli was, you know, trying to like gauge it or whatever, and then maybe just a split second got unfocused, and then his body weight shifted, and then that was all she wrote, right? Like, if your front end, like, hits any type of square edge bump, like,
yeah,
it's gone.
So there was 4 points after the first moto, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
So if Chase won, he would have had to hope be, like, a third or fourth?
Fourth, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, did you guys see Chase after the first moto? That poor guy looked so defeated.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
And I
yeah.
heard him just talking to Lars, like, I tried.
And
he
did.
So sad.
Like,
yeah.
He did, because for how much he had led of that, and Eli just tracked him down. And when Eli got around him, it was on. Like, you could hear the bike even click into the next, like, level and just check out.
Even that last lap that Chase put down, though, I mean, that was – he reeled him in a bit, but
– So, back to what we were saying about the 5 minutes thing. I wonder, like, Chase could never use, like, if I didn't have 5 more minutes, it wouldn't be this. But there were so many times in that second moto where you could see it. I didn't think 5 minutes was going to make that big of a difference, but then that first 250 moto, because I always have my watch on me, and I got the 2-lap card, I'm like, yo, dude, there should be 10 minutes left. So it did feel like it went so much faster. I could see where things would change. It's not what you think it is, but those races did feel considerably shorter watching.
Yeah. I'd even make it down to the hills to film. I was like, on my way walking there, and I saw all you guys walking back. I'm like, oh, it's two laps, crap.
Yeah. What's that guy? Who's the little Trevor Nelson? Was like, hey guys, there's only three laps left. He's like, he came up to me and said that, and he was telling everyone. I'm like, okay, thanks for the considerate notification, guy. But I don't know. It was a cool race. I was glad I was there to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Glad I was there to see. I mean, it's pretty funny. Through the three decades of my career, you know, I remember little things. I'm going to remember this. I saw Eli's last national. Like, I got to see Villopoto's only GP win in Thailand. You know, Stewart's perfect year, all that kind of stuff. But, like, yeah, Saturday was pretty cool to see that. And then Eli has been so sick all year to deal with and, like, so easy to talk to and forthcoming in his interviews and stuff. Like, it was cool talking to him afterwards, even though you had gone for hours weekend. Mm-hmm. I still threw the camera on him, and he was great.
You know it's going to be a good one when he does the head shake, though.
Yeah.
You know it's going to be good, and I'm like, yes.
Yeah, I like how you're all, yeah, how was it? He's all, first off, it was freaking hot.
Okay, we got to talk about the heat thing because so many people are so, like, one way or the other about it. We've had hotter races. It was definitely hot, but it wasn't the hottest one we've ever had.
No.
Not even the hottest, like, SoCal National, for sure, in September.
Dude, the hottest SoCal National I've ever been to was Lake Elsinore.
Yeah.
And then there was also flies at that one.
Oh, yeah.
I felt like I was in the Amityville horror movie.
At that and then the flying easy ups. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think the worst national I've ever been to in my life was the Troy, Ohio National. Because it was humid.
So humid there. Yeah.
That was.
And, like, I mean, yeah, the races were shorter, but you still seen guys going backwards.
Oh, yeah. You were going to get hit by that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Guys were going backwards. Guys were feeling it. Especially, like, maybe some of the young kids, too. Like, you know, they were moving up. They felt it. But, yeah, I seen a lot of guys going backwards in that second moto, for sure.
All things considered, too, to think of all the obstacles they faced. I think that's the best we've ever seen Paula's, like, dirt stay through a whole day.
Dude.
It never got dust. Even on the back parts where you know it just looks like Baghdad, it was fine.
I never saw any dust except for when McAdoo went flying off the track on the last lap.
Yeah.
Man.
Dude.
Poor guy with Paula, right?
We, like, need to just do an
exempt. What did he do? Did he just hit a whole endo? Or?
I've talked to, like, probably 30 people, and I don't know anyone that saw the whole thing. But from talking to some of the mechanics last night, it sounds like he possibly either hit the tower or just hit a kicker. Because he got close to that tower a couple laps.
Last lap, man. Tower, last lap.
Just lost the bike, went off
the
side.
Any word on the flagger?
Two legs, I heard.
Yeah.
Both
two
legs.
Femurs?
No, I think
Wait, he hits. Hit a flagger.
Oh, he took the flagger out.
Yeah.
They were both flipping through the air.
The bike hit him.
Yeah, the bike and the flagger were flipping through the air.
Oh, poor guy.
Yeah, I think tib fib on both legs is what I heard.
So there was two
Cameron
Alpine Stars rides out?
Yes. Yeah, well, I saw Cameron going back, and I'm like, oh, he's out of it. And then I see this guy in a blue shirt go back. I'm like, what's wrong with that guy's legs?
Oh, my gosh, man.
That's so sad.
Because I don't know if you guys saw, but the Alpine Stars medic unit was taking, like, track crew guys all day. Like,
oh, really?
I saw two track crew guys get taken by the mule and for, like, heat exhaustion or whatever and get thrown into an ice bath outside of it.
Oh, my gosh.
They were busy.
Like, I've hit someone on the side of the track. And like, dude, like, it's
big surprise.
Like,
you almost hit me.
Yeah. What? No, that was a what state fair?
Yeah, that's scary.
Fudge. But no, like, that time that photographer lady I hit. That freestyle photocross. Yeah. Dislocated her knee, bro. And I'm like, I'm freaking out. I'm like, her legs all pointed, like, to the side and everything. It's like the worst feeling ever, right? Because you don't mean to do it. They're just there.
Supercross is one thing, the Nationals is another.
Because
they're so fast, and, like, that's why we have to, like, have that safety meeting every morning. But
Like, even last week at Ironman, Bodner. I mean,
Dino hit
him. Dude, you got to have your head on a swivel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Mm. Damn. Yeah, McAdoo's okay.
We
thought he had a concussion or something, right? But he texted me right back. So
oh, really? Yeah, I had heard he had a concussion.
Yeah, I heard he didn't know what had happened up until.
Yeah, I heard he had no idea.
Okay, well, he texted me. I'm fine.
I'm sure he did. But no, I was worried shoulder right away because that ride back in the mule, he was like this. But I heard shoulder's fine. It's just
that would be terrible. I mean, he's got a wedding coming up, right?
Dude.
So, like, for him to, like, get married in a sling or something, that would suck.
Yeah.
19 days, right?
Yeah.
Just it was like when it happened, I was standing right by Tedesco and a couple other guys, And for all of us, we're like, oh, who was it? And then I went and saw, I was like, oh, Cameron. And everyone was just like, damn.
Yeah, because he was in fourth right there, man. That was going to be – that's good for him.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He was sending it those last laps.
Yeah,
he was sending it.
Okay, but back to the 450s. What else? There's other shit that happened that was good. Like,
I think Christian did – I mean, that was awesome to see Christian lead laps at the SoCal race. Mm-hmm. I really can't wait to see him on a 450 and just full-time. I think it's going to be good. Even for Dunge, I mean, that got him Dunge in the championship standings. Ryan did pretty good to get up and going again from the couple little incidents that he had.
Dude, Kenny, that last moto. I thought he was out. Like, he was holding his arm. He wasn't getting
took
up right
minute.
Away.
Yeah.
And then he just was like, especially for how hot it was, he was charging all moto. Like, all moto.
Tough end of the summer because he went down in the first one, too.
Yeah.
In the first lap. Yeah.
Poor Amart. Last race of the season. Yeah, like he was, he rested all week. He said, oh, yeah, my shoulder's fine. And then he crashes again. And
no, he didn't crash.
Oh, yeah, he hurt his back
right?
out
during practice.
And those rollers in the back, I think, right?
Yeah.
Those things look vicious.
Yes.
I walked up to him, you know, before the first moto, and I had my camera on. I was like, are we going to get some Anton going to make you cry? And how was your weekend? And he goes, no, man, I'm not even racing.
Oh,
I blew my back out. I didn't even fall.
Oh, jeez. Those are the worst.
Yeah, that sucks because it's not the way he wants to go out, right?
No.
Yeah, and they sent him out like first on the parade lap. Mm-hmm. That was cool, though.
But you know what sucks about that? The average SoCal fan doesn't appreciate Alex Martin the way
everyone else
does, or fans back east would, right?
Yeah.
Like I
but
saw
he
him
did
waving
get a couple. Yeah. He did get a couple retirement tour laps this summer, like scattered in and out.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Yeah. Shout out to Alex too, because he is he's very good about tagging us in all the photos. He's always very pumped.
Yeah.
Troll Train, like the vlog, we're always the thumbnail. So that's cool. Alex has been a big help to us.
Yeah.
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 He's good.
Okay, Kenny. Any word on him yet?
Still no deal signed. I know a lot of people have been trying to get him. There was even talk of like, you know, the changing brands thing
okay,
is on.
Okay, if he changed brands, is he still gonna race a Honda in World Supercross?
They don't even know that.
He doesn't even have a team set for
they have
that
nothing
yet.
For
the
that
team
yet.
Hasn't. He hasn't chosen the team.
No,
that's coming up quick too, man.
Yep. No, bikes have to be out of like in the containers to go to England next week.
Yeah. I was gonna say. I've already
I was talking to HGP. Like they're building bikes today.
This week,
like a lot of bikes.
Moto Concepts already has their boxes and crates, right?
Yeah. Well, they've been
their
on
bikes
it.
And,
them and then Club MX and you know I even seen like those new boxes that they ship. I guess they're the average one that they. You know, have like for the GPs and stuff.
Cool,
I still think they're cool,
oh,
right?
Yeah, it looks sick.
Like a bike box. You can fit two bikes in there and it's badass, right?
Yeah, I talked to some Honda people. There's still nothing there. I think there was more like, hey, let's try to get back to what he was. But for World Supercross, he would almost have to be on a Honda. Cause
yeah, how are you going to have time to get used to anything else?
But then.
But also, it's Kenny.
The
right?
teams
but
that
also,
are open.
Yeah, but then you got to get parts because it's not like Kenny's going to be like, just send me some revalve stock suspension. Like, he's going to have a couple good things to go even do that one race. Yeah. The first one, even. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hype on that thing is quickly building up. Like, a lot of moving parts to get that going. Eli's in.
Josh
a lot of
Grant
stuff to get that in. Yeah.
Josh Granton. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I wonder if, I guess there's no way Eli's going to be on the new bike.
No, they don't think so.
Yeah. He was raving about that thing to me.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, it's a big deal.
Yeah, I've heard nothing but good things about that bike. They had it on display.
Did you sit on it?
I didn't sit on it, no, but I walked around it.
I jumped over the rope.
Yeah.
And I sat on it. It's thin.
Is it?
It's thin, yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's going to come late. Who knows if they'll have parts for it. I mean, shit, Yamahas, they're freaking good, you know. Even the last year's bike.
Look at this man putting in work.
Oh, dude. So even the last year's bike's proven. Yeah, trying to slide in there. Yeah, we're good.
Yeah, I'm interested to see, though, like, how – obviously, Star will have the bike dialed, right? But these other teams, like Club and stuff, if they get enough time to even go racing with that bike in Supercross.
But even again, as we've seen from the KTM deal this year, it's not a failure if you don't get the new one, especially if it's going to put you at a detriment and you're a team that needs to grow. Because like next year, for what the Club guys are going to be going through, with Phil coming back, with Garrett coming back, with getting a 450 guy, they have a lot on their plate already to try to test a new bike.
Totally.
And I'm assuming, like if they're a Yamaha-supported team, I'm assuming that there's some type of list, right? That they're like, hey, these guys need the bikes first. Like, let's get them a bike.
You would think, but AEO gets some help from KTM. I mean,
even
they still were like,
you got to find your vendors that are going to have the stuff ready too. Like, I had heard from the Star guys this week, the bolt kit was the big deal. Like, that was the big project of figuring out, like, what's the stuff that we need.
Yeah.
And so.
Bolt kit?
Yep.
Yeah.
Wow. I figure FMF probably already has a pipe for it.
I heard suspension, though, just bolts right on. No big changes on
suspension.
That.
Suspension.
I heard that. Isn't that the same?
Oh, that's really good. That's great news to me. That's music to my ears.
Really?
Yes.
Like, you have maybe some Yamaha suspension right now?
No. Or?
Oh, the stuff that got stolen.
Oh, did you hear about that? They found it.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Yeah, yes, we talked about it on the show before. Yeah.
Yeah, they found it.
Where?
Ross knows where it's at. It's right. It's at KYB.
Didn't some guy try to, like, hey, I have these forks, but they're too stiff?
I don't know. I talked to Jim Roach or something. They found it, like, at some salvage yard or something. I don't know. Like, in San Diego or something.
Did they
idea.
Give your money back?
No, I never paid for the suspension. Oh. I just paid for the bike. The suspension, it cost way too much money. I got the invoice. I'm like, yeah, no, I can't pay for that.
Wasn't there a story where some guy called KYB and he's like, I got these forks. Was that you?
I heard that story. I don't know.
I heard that
kind of harsh.
Yeah, they're kind of harsh. How can I get these redone? And they're like, if you send us those, you're never getting them back. Was
yeah, pretty much. I don't remember. No, but like, I guess they gave them, like, the people that had sent Ross in, like, the suspension, maybe. They're like, hey, we want to get this stuff done. They're like, hey, you're not supposed to have this shit. So I think they ended up giving them like a B kit deal. Yeah, but it's – I talked to someone. They said it's sitting there just hanging out at KYB.
Just framed.
I mean, not framed, no. But like, I'm like, man, that thing needs to be – if that setting's still in there, like, let it get put to use. You know? Oh, man, that would be great.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I would love that.
Benny Bloss did well, right?
He did.
Freddie did good.
They both did good.
They were
like,
ripping.
They ended up on a good note.
Next to each other, right?
Yeah, in and out the whole time, yeah.
BBMX. Mm-hmm. It was good.
It was good, yeah.
They even did an engine swap after Moto 1 on Freddie's bike. It was nothing crazy, right? I think it was just one of the sight glasses was cracked.
Oh, okay.
Might have been leaking a little bit of oil. But, yeah, I mean, they don't have, like, the full canopy. They just have easy ups.
Yep.
My man Derek... Like, say what you want about the guy. If something needs to be done, he doesn't care. If it's pouring down rain, if it's 200 degrees, he's doing it.
Yep.
Like, I mean, they just have, like, those small easy ups out mm-hmm. there, right? You know, like, and just swapping an engine. Mm-hmm. It's just hot
and
as hell.
In his Andretti shirt.
Yeah, in his Andretti shirt, right? Like, oh, man.
It's good to see Benny figured out the helmet thing.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, dude. I don't know. I don't know that whole deal, but I think he was very uncomfortable in Iron Man, from what I hear.
He is, like, very nitpicky about his stuff.
Oh, yeah, he's very nitpicky. Yes.
It's Benny we're talking about here.
Yes, yes.
But.
Yeah, that was good, honestly, and even because of that crash in the first bit, you watch the top 10 for those first three laps, and I'm like, whoa, dude, what a top 10.
Yeah.
Grant Harwin.
Mm-hmm. Grant Harwin was ripping. He was raving. So he ran a paddle both motos mm-hmm. for the
Pirelli
start.
Though, right?
Yeah, Pirelli. Yeah. Pirelli for both. I mean, I don't know what he originally runs or if that's what he runs all year. I don't know. But he ran a scoop tire for both motos and just started up front. I mean, dude, what did he get overall? Like 11th?
I don't know. I know his pipe came off first moto, though.
Yeah.
Oh, it was blowing packing out. That was a good one.
Just hitting the freaking rear brake caliper the whole moto. But. Dude rode good. I mean, you even seen AP. I think AP, towards the end of the moto, because AP was coming from the back, was revving his bike at Carlin, thinking he was a lapper.
Yes, yes.
Thinking he was a lapper. I'm like, nah, dude. He's riding in front of you.
I said the same thing. I'm like, bro, you guys are on the same lap.
It took him like two laps to get around him, and AP's just revving his bike. I don't even think he knew who he was racing against or what place they were in. But I don't know. I thought it was cool for Harlan. I mean, that was a Kiefering testing Yamaha or a Honda. So, I mean, yeah, that was super, super cool.
I like Gardner with the camelback.
I did too, yeah. He had a good day.
Yeah.
Very good day. It was 16, 14 or something? 16,
was Gardner 15? Wearing O'Neil. Orange gear?
No, it was like highlighter.
Yeah.
Highlighter gear.
With an awry.
No, there's another guy with it.
Dude, there's four camelbacks I saw.
Yeah.
Because
I asked one guy, I was like, is that easy to drink? And he goes, no. Like, it's hard to drink.
Yeah.
I think the funniest quote from How Was Your Weekend was asked, AP, like, what are you going to, you know, how long is your off season? Where he goes, oh, dude, it's short. And I was like, okay, so for those 2 weeks, what are you going to eat? And he goes, oh, dude, I just want fish tacos. Because I want fish tacos. I want a lot of sushi. I'm going to have a beer. and I might dabble in some pizza.
Oh, God.
He's so funny.
Yeah, it's good.
I'm surprised fish tacos aren't on the program.
Yeah, right?
I don't know.
Right? Yeah, who knows? Probably something about flour and corn tortillas or some
yeah.
shit.
Yeah, going to get a mercury poisoning or something. Yeah.
So, anyway, last week we said we were giving away a pair of Pro Taper clamp-on grips to the comment that we liked. And so Magnatrax, I don't know the guy's real name, but if you're listening, his comment is, been listening since the fall of Transworld and didn't realize that Swap had a website. He's only been listening to the podcast.
Yep.
Right?
Oh, he goes, nice.
In hindsight, Transworld was probably a good name to distance yourself from. Damn, the world has changed, right? It's not tranny world.
Yeah.
Right? It's non-binary world. Big ups to y'all from Idaho. Good idea on the giveaway. I'll click around your website for a while. God save us. Magnatrax. So, Magnatrax, you're obviously listening to this. Slide into my DMs on Instagram at Swapmoto. And send me your address, and we will get a set of these Pro Taper clamp-on grips sent off to you. So we have another set for today. So, again, go to swapmotolive.com. Not YouTube, not the podcast server. You got to go to our website, our homepage, comment on this post why we should give you these grips, and we'll send another pair out. Pro Taper clamp-on half-waffle grips.
We can see your IP addresses and your email accounts,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, so don't even think about
it. So if you're an employee, we see you.
Dahmer.
We see you.
Dahmer.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Dahmer. What did he say? I love looking at that guy.
Look how good he looks. Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez. Yeah. Well, we had to use the wide lens.
450 stuff, too. I'm trying to think more and more. Dungeon's done, though. That came out.
Yeah.
That's got to be something that we talk
sucks.
About.
He's done.
Which we kind of knew. We had said that a couple weeks ago. There were so many people saying he was going to keep going, but he had kind of been hinting to me like, no, we're not. So then to hear that Saturday, I was sort of surprised by that he would make it known that fast, but cool to hear him say like, oh, no, I've scratched the itch. I'm good now. I don't need it again. Because you got to think 5 years of not knowing. That's got to be a big what if for him for so long.
For him to come out 5 years, though, like and to do what he did this year, I think, holy cow, right?
Yeah, 5 years.
I mean, to be even top 10 or anything, be competitive after five yeah. years. I mean, it's Ryan Dungey we're talking about, yeah, but he didn't get a podium. He came up short there. But, dude, for him to be, what, fifth, sixth in the championship?
Sixth, yeah.
Sixth in the championship, that is beyond amazing.
Yeah. Are we, collectively as a group, are we surprised that he did not get a podium?
I'm surprised. Like, after I seen him ride the first few rounds, I'm a little bit surprised he didn't get on the podium.
Yeah.
I mean, he had plenty of opportunities there a little bit. I think, I mean, everyone's saying it. Washougal was the hurtful one, right? Like, he was going to do it there. And mm-hmm. then, you know, he had the bike issue. But, hey, it happens.
Yeah, because when he did so well right off the bat, I was like, oh, here we go. Dunge is back up there, going to be like denying our How Was Your Weekends.
But he's been great. He was great for
How Was Your Weekends. Yeah, he was great all year.
Yeah.
But I'm shocked he didn't make it.
Yeah.
I am too.
And then every time he and Christian were battling, I always think, I wonder what it's like for Christian to think, dude, I'm just coming out on top with these battles with Ryan Dungey.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Crazy.
Battle of the two former retirees. But I don't know.
Yeah, I was thinking something with Dunge this year, like maybe 3 weeks ago, because I saw the Wheaties box. I've seen a bunch of people come get the Wheaties box autographed all summer. I saw, like, Dave Prater did a video interview in his office, and there's the Wheaties box. I want to talk to Ryan about just like that, and I wonder how many Weevils are in these boxes of Wheaties now, too. Like, how many people's bags just need to be thrown away?
Yeah.
You know? But, like, to see Ryan come back and to see all that stuff that happened, and even when I asked him after Ironman, like, how fun it had been to go through with his dad. Like, great year for him. Mm-hmm. And there's no need that he should go away entirely now. We'll come back to the races, man. You can see there's a place for you. Just keep coming back and showing up just to hang out, race, you know, something every year, ride something. Yeah.
You know what's cool is that coincidentally, you know, Cooper took the summer off and that freed up Carlos mm-hmm. for the big reunion tour, right?
Look at all the like conspiracy theories that people were putting out. What's Carlos going to do next year if Dunge comes back? Is he going to – what guy is he going to pick? Yeah. This. And it's like, oh, yeah, dude, not even a factor now.
That sounds like a vital conspiracy.
It was.
It was.
Yeah. I wonder what it was like for Jade to work alongside him like that again, you know?
Yeah.
Ryan had said that was a chance for him to see his brother that he wouldn't get to see because you got to think, like, Jade's the only one that's out here.
Yeah.
Because they're all back, like him, Blake's there. They're all within, like, I think, an hour of each other.
Yeah. Right. So what about Rod Bell on the HEP bike?
He did good.
He didn't throw up.
I think he did a little bit, yeah.
Oh, no. He didn't throw up during qualifying.
No, he didn't throw up during qualifying. I think he threw up a little bit after the first moto.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because he told me he always throws up during qualifying, mm-hmm. like on his hot lap.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he didn't throw up after that.
Yeah, I don't know. It's crazy. He throws up a lot.
Yeah.
I don't know. He's got, like, a stomach issue or something. Like, I think it nerves get to him so gnarly that he just bleh, and throws up.
I asked his mechanic, like, dude, how was it last week? He goes, he handed me the bike, said, I threw up all over the place. He goes, I almost threw up.
Yeah. You see someone throw up or, like, you get a whiff of it and you're like, ugh.
You're like jackass.
Yeah. Yeah. It causes a chain reaction. Yeah.
What Welton raced too, right?
Yeah Welton did.
They were right there back and forth a couple times too. It was like a nice Suzuki battle for the top
yeah.
10 there.
Yeah.
He had some retro gear on. Welton did.
They were running the Hallman stuff.
Hallman stuff. Yeah.
The yellow and blue.
When I first saw it, what is that?
I mean, yeah. I mean, for one of the hottest races of the year, there was a lot of people out there that I guess their gear companies sent them like the thickest shit.
The amount of people there was all black. My God.
Yeah. I even asked Dino. He's like, I was like, hey, dude, you like Jeff Emig style today? Like, just trying to like, you know, spook out all the young kids. But he's like, yeah, no, it wasn't my choice. So, yeah, he was a little upset with it. But
how was Dino after?
He was not emotional at all.
He was. I noticed that in the pits, too. He was just like, oh, whatever.
Yeah, I was like, oh, so.
Is that yawn off?
Your last national, you know. I go, are there any emotions? He goes, the hell no, man. Because we weren't having any fun out here.
Yeah, I think it might hit him a little bit later than it does for the other people, right?
Like, yeah.
Well, because he still has Supercross.
Yeah, he still has Supercross.
He's got a lot on his plate in the next few months. Yeah, yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
I mean, I think his flight leaves this afternoon, and he's going to...
To Florida.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So he had his baby shower yesterday?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Dude, how about that video where Sarah gave him some New Balance shoes?
Oh, dude, they're so good.
They're so fun.
Yeah, I seen him last night. Like, I met up with him while they're eating dinner. And, dude, like, his kit was so funny. You know, he looked like the gnarliest dad
Jean
ever.
Shorts,
like,
right?
The only thing he was missing was, like, a push mower and, like a blower or something, you know?
Fanny pack.
Yeah.
Dude, so she's due when he's, like, supposed to be wherever in the world.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
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 She's due, like, mid-October or something?
Yeah, she's stressing.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Not stressing it too bad, but she's like, yeah, he's going to leave and go to Australia, and that's, like, right on the time.
Well, no, and he was saying a little bit last night, and I'm like, it's one of those things where, yeah, you're racing World Supercross, but for what he's got going on, he can't really, like, go there early and enjoy it. It's kind of like an in-and-out type deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whoa. There we go.
There we go.
Well, the first kid is always late, right? Wasn't yours late?
No.
My friend
was
early.
We had to induce him, but he took forever.
Oh, induce stuff, but, like, I don't know. Maybe he's got time to get back.
Hopefully,
yeah.
Well, I mean, it was just like RJ this past weekend.
Yeah.
Paula. His baby was due yesterday.
Yeah.
But he made it home. I texted him last night, and he said, I get to live for another year because the baby's not here yet. So he's having it. They're having it today.
Okay.
But, Dino. It was cool to see Malcolm race a national, even though he fell in the first turn with that big pileup, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it was good for him to come through the pack, too. Like, he was ripping that first moto, you know, with whatever he had going on his side. It was a burn, right? It wasn't like a slice open.
New Jersey was burned.
He said it was a burn. I said, was it a pipe or a burnout from a tire? And he goes, I don't know. It hurts, though.
It's a perfect circle on the back of the jersey.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah.
So you think it's a pipe?
Probably a pipe.
Yeah.
Because he was, like, at the bottom of the pile.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How good did those Huskies look?
Those are sick.
They look sick.
Insane.
Was Bro Show just like, yeah.
That's the Bro Show era, right?
That is badass.
No,
yeah.
the white with the blue and yellow stripe, that is like, I remember the first time I ever seen Bro Show as a factory rider. I was at Indian Dunes racing my three-wheeler, and I was like, that's a black guy. but yeah, his Husky was along those lines with that stripe. Yeah.
So I personally think that it's the best-looking Husky out there right now.
For
and
sure.
I think that that's the kit that they need to run in Supercross next year.
They need to have white frames next year for Supercross all year. Mm-hmm.
They did a very good job keeping that under wraps, too.
Yes.
Yeah. They even went, like, super early, 8 o'clock on Friday morning to tech the bike so nobody would see them.
I asked Nathan Ramsey about it. I was like, dude, the retro kit's cool. And he goes, yeah, it's retro. I don't have any idea what year it's retro to. And I'm all, bro, that's Andy Jefferson, like, 84, 85 era. And he's like, oh, sure was a lot of work.
Sure,
because they powder coated the frame and everything, right?
And everything was under wraps. Like, people came into the race shop last week, and they're like, you got to go.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It was cool. I was kind of surprised Rockstar let it happen and wasn't black and yellow.
They've been a lot really more cool. lenient this year. Mm-hmm. I mean, even
with the special edition helmets.
Special edition helmets, all that stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
I think the only thing that they were pissed about was what maybe Malcolm's helmet that one time.
The all gold one?
Yeah, the all gold one.
Yeah, and it's funny, they were mad about that, and then a couple rounds later, they're like, ah, yeah, we should do different stuff.
That was pretty sick, yeah.
Yeah.
Dean's helmet those last few was cool.
Yeah.
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 Wow, Roger Larson, just a change
changing. Maker. Changing things, yep.
Yeah.
Dude.
So, James, how cool was it to see James?
Dude.
Like, you saw him at Bud's when he was there?
I saw him, but I didn't get a chance to talk to him, and I didn't even talk to him this Saturday, but I saw him, like, watching during practice, and then I saw him and Big James standing there watching together. I'm like, yeah. That's cool. I'm not going to talk. That's cool.
Yeah, because I was shooting practice, and I'm like, dude, this is too hot. And I was walking back for practice over, and he was walking the other way. I was like, oh, man. And he walks, he goes, I'm sweating like I got a court date. But, yeah, he was super funny. Dude, the funniest thing he told me is because I was like, oh, I pulled the GoPro out and I was vlogging him. Well, dude, you look super fit again. Are you training? He goes, I'm training for something, but I can't tell you.
Oh.
But he told me he's 145 again.
Really?
Oh, wow.
And I'm all, dude, how big did you get? Because you was living large when I saw you at Orlando.
He's 145.
That's nuts, dude.
Is he 45 pounds in dreads? Dude, that's a lot of hair. He's got a lot.
He looked
it's
like
funny
the,
to see him because you don't
like
see
the
him
Malcolm,
for so long.
Yes. Yeah, Salt Lake City.
The cartoon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That guy, dude, that guy was at Bud's walking around in that full Malcolm thing.
No way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Was it as hot as yesterday?
It was hotter.
It was hotter, yeah.
Dude.
But, dude, James guy was like, hey, dude, how big did you get? And he goes, why you got to focus on the negative? And I'm like, no, seriously, just in comparison, because you were large when I saw you. And he goes, I don't know, because I stood on the scale, and, you know, the digital scale, he goes, I saw a 2 and said, ah! So, dude, think about it. He's lost 50 pounds.
At least.
Yeah.
Because, dude, he was big.
It's crazy.
I don't know.
Big boy.
Inspiration for Dahmer.
Inspiration for me. Heck. I got 10 days, I think. Wait, what's today? Today's the 5th. I got 9 days until my surgery. And then I'll probably...
Whoa. Another surgery? Take the shit out?
Yeah, to take it out.
But a take the shit out surgery is not as gnarly, right?
No, it's not as gnarly. Like, you wake up and feels, like, amazing.
Can you leave the stitches in this time?
Yeah, you should probably do that this time.
Yeah. I'll probably leave it in for a couple days longer. But a
couple days.
Yeah, I mean, the last time I got my stitches out, or the last time I got my pins out after my fusion, they're like, hey, as soon as the incisions heal, you take your stitches out. You can ride. So I'm hoping that I get my stitches out. I mean, here in about like a week or so, or afterwards,
my.
Or 2 weeks. And then I should be able to ride. But like once I have this next surgery, I mean, training's started. So yeah. I've been living it up the last couple months, like eating everything, fucking gaining weight. I feel like a bag of dicks, but like I'm excited to start the process over again.
What did Davey say when he saw you then?
Not much. He's okay. Like, well, I mean, he's pretty much like, hey, you ready to start training? And I'm like, not yet. I still got a couple weeks left. Got a couple weeks of living left. But yeah, I mean, it's coming up, and I feel like, you know, and I've expressed that I want to race a full season next year, and yeah, so once training starts, it ain't gonna stop. So I'm living life up right now to
full season outdoors too.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Okay. Is this the last normal off season?
I think so.
I think so.
Yeah, I think so. I, with everything changing, you know, I mean, it's just the way everything's going, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if, I mean, it's not many more races, but
it's gonna go later.
It's gonna go later. You're seeing, like, even in other sports, everything's changing. Like golf, the LIV Golf thing, it stirred everything up. This year, World Supercross. It supposedly didn't stir everything up, but a lot of things have changed in 1 year. So, yeah, I think this is the last normal year I think we're going
to
see.
I was talking to Peanut, Dylan's mechanic at Star, and he's like, yeah, we'll get a little bit of a break, but you got to think next year, like, we'll be racing well into October. Like, multiple races that we still have to have bikes and all that stuff for, and that's usually when the break is. It was one thing to do one Monster Cup, or your guy might do Paris or Geneva or whatever. But then, yeah, that month break where everybody would take off that first part of October or the next part of it, that's gone now because you have to start in November and you're racing those three.
Yeah.
Yikes. All right, let's take a break to hear from our sponsors, and then we'll talk about 250s.
Racetech is the world's largest aftermarket motorcycle suspension modification company with over 35 years experience personalizing your suspension setups. Racetech Gold Valves provide a plush feel with drastically improved bottoming resistance and increased traction.
Hey everyone, Don Moetta here. Over the past 20 years, I've built a ton of cool motocross project bikes. When it comes to choosing a great wheel set, my first call is always to the crew at WUSA. Importers and distributors of Talon, Kite, Hahn, and Edge hubs, the wheel building team at W is unrivaled when it comes to lacing them up to DID or Excel rims. Let's be honest now. Next, cleaning air filters or changing oil. Tightening spokes is one of the most tedious jobs when it comes to working on your bike. When it comes to wheel sets from W, though, you know that they'll stay straight and true, and the spokes will almost always stay tight. There's a reason that factory teams and top riders everywhere rely on W. When it comes to anything wheel-related, your one-stop shop is WUSA.com. Check them out.
Hey, this is Colt Nichols of the Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha team, and I rely on Guiltless Food Co. to keep me fueled properly, feeling 100%, and is super convenient. It's healthy food that doesn't suck. Sign up at GuiltlessFoodCo.com.
Out here, on the edge, failure is no option. Here, you don't compromise. Off-road, on-road, on the track, off the grid. Sunstar sprockets and brake discs come installed in more motorcycles and all-terrain vehicles than any other in the world. Period. The engineers who design your bike trust and spec Sunstar for the same reason you should. Because here, on the edge, failure is no option. Sunstar, number one in sprockets and brake discs.
What's up? This is Christian Craig. As a motocross racer, being in top physical shape is a must, and my favorite way to train is cycling. And whether it's road biking or mountain biking, I rely on Roy Cyclery to keep my bikes in perfect running order.
Roy Cyclery has been servicing Old Town Upland, California since 1962. Mention the Swapmoto Live podcast for additional discounts in the shop.
Hey guys, it's Ryan Villapoto. Now that I'm living the retired life and not bound to factory team sponsors, I'm able to choose my partners when it comes to building my bikes. I choose Backyard Designs to create my motorcycle graphics because they do a great job. Their kits look great, go on easy, and last long.
Backyard Design has the most comprehensive and user-friendly graphic website in the sport. Use the discount code SWAPMOTO at checkout for a discount at backyarddesignsusa.com.
G'day guys, this is 9-time X Games gold medalist Jared McNeil. Off the motocross bike, I spend plenty of time cross-training on my intense mountain bike. From the super fast and efficient Sniper cross-country bike to the aggressive Primer and Tracer trail bikes, or even the amazing Taser e-bike. Every intense is designed and developed in the United States and built to the highest standards. A life on two wheels certainly includes pedals too. So give the crew at IntenseCycles.com a look.
Everyone, welcome back to the Pro Taper Kickstart Podcast. 250s. I mean, the thing I was going to say is about RJ Balin to go have his kid. But kind of anticlimactic, I think. Like, because Jett clinched it in the first moto, right?
Yeah.
They didn't give him his plate in between, or there was no like, yeah, after the first moto. It's just like, whatever. Mm-hmm. But I think the big talk in the first moto was the Hunter Lawrence-Joe Shimoda collision.
And I think people over there at GasGas were a little pissed off about that.
PC?
Well, I mean PC, yeah, but GasGas too, because they're like, hey, Honda does it, and they don't get DQ'd. What the fuck? Pretty much.
So it's weird how this one's gone, because – in the moment, I think so many people were like, oh, yeah, he made a mistake. And then he did that interview, and then he had said, like, oh, yeah, I was going to hit him a little bit. Like, I was going to hit him. So I think in watching it, I was standing right behind it, and when he hit, you could hear the 25 people that were at Paul that day all scream. That was like the Qatar GPs a little bit, but it was fun. But you could hear everybody like, oh, and I like look over, and then I see Joe getting up. I was like, oh, okay, like maybe just something happened. And then to see the replay, and then you think like, oh, okay, maybe it was this. And then you hear the interview, and you're like, oh, okay, so it's this then. Like, very wild to hear how that story like ebbed and flowed through the day.
Yeah. I don't think it was intended to be as bad as it was, but I think that whenever Hunter came down that hill very aggressively, he got a kick on a kicker. Mm-hmm. And, you know, whenever your rear wheel's off the ground, you're not using your rear brake. So, like, he carried a lot of speed into the side of Joe.
Knocked his hand off.
Yeah. I mean, was Joe, like, off. How pissed was Joe at Hunter?
Oh, yes. He was furious, dude.
Because they're friends, furious. Right? Or is it,
I don't think they're
– They're not as close as him and Jett. Yeah. Okay.
He was very pissed in the rig, though, I heard.
Yeah.
And I think he can thank Hunter, though, a lot for that performance in the second moto, because I think he was full anger.
They were in a chase, right, for second in points.
Oh, yeah.
It was pretty close.
But it was – I think he had 13 points or something.
No. If
the first moto?
If Jett would have let Hunter by, it would have been tight.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was tight.
But then the hit, like, yeah, it beat Joe up because, I mean, he hit so hard, but the clutch lever was knocked out. The bike was pretty tweaked up. So then, like, that explains those last couple laps when Justin got him. But, dude, to see Joe come out and rip like that second one,
he
unbelievable.
Was going
and he had a bad week leading up, like, talking to people in his camp. Like, he was not riding well this week. I mean, he wasn't even – they were even thinking about not building a bike for him, you know? Like, so he was not 100% for sure.
Even funny to hear him on the podium where he's like, I don't want to talk about the pass. Yeah, it was, like, a little dirty, and, yeah, it pissed me off. And I was like, wow, dude, Joe, like, check. Like, he's so good. Yeah.
He was even in a good mood on Saturday night after the deal. Like I seen him like break dancing on the dance floor. It was good. Yeah,
dude. Okay. His butt patch.
They changed it.
Practice. So good.
Oh yeah.
So for good. Practice, why did they change it?
I don't know.
Okay, so, I mean, you saw it, right? Happy ending with a little smiley face. Before the first moto, you know, he had the drippy smiley face on.
Yeah.
And I'm all, what's up with your butt patch? Before I saw that, because I had heard about the happy ending one, and he goes, oh, it's like my tattoo, you know, I have that tattoo. And I'm all, what? Because I thought happy ending. And he goes, and I go, no, the happy ending one. And he goes, oh, it's because it's the last race, and it's going to be a happy day. I'm happy ending. I don't know. I got to ask him again.
I'm sure. Well, I'm sure it came from Matt, fellow Asian.
Yeah.
Because he does a couple of those butt patches, so.
But still, dude.
I thought this shit was funny. I thought it was.
I thought it was hilarious.
No, yeah, it's super funny, but like, I hope he knew what it meant.
I don't know.
Yeah, probably not.
I think he might not have known.
No, I don't think he knew either.
Because, you know, happy ending to movies and stuff, so you hear the term.
Yeah.
Right? But I don't know if you know it meant hand job.
Probably not. You probably didn't know.
Oh, man.
I think that makes it even better, though.
Yeah, it does.
And then you have that Vara Lee bell helmet. That was sick.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. Don't get any ideas, freaking, you know, like, hey, Joe, like, I'm going to teach you what this means. Like,
yeah,
taking him around Southern California.
Don't do what Twitch did to Winky and Taco.
Oh, man.
But I'm just like, God, dude, did that come from Mora?
I'm sure it did. He does a lot of the stuff for Joe, I'm pretty sure. So I'm almost certain he did that.
This shit's so
funny.
We got
to find out. Dude, yeah, because
Joe has a tattoo?
The drippy face thing, yeah.
The drippy face.
Oh, that's sick.
Side. I don't know. Is it green or is it just black?
I don't know. I haven't seen it.
Oh, I thought you said he showed it to you.
No, he told me about a couple. He showed me the ear piercings. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's very proud about that stuff.
Yeah. Very Americanized.
Yes.
How long are you here, Anton?
Till tomorrow night.
Oh, nice. Okay. All right.
It's kind of weird having him here, huh?
It is. It is.
Huh?
I like being back. It's fine. I'm not moving back, but I like being back.
But, okay, 2BD class, Joe, untouchable, that second moto.
Untouchable.
See, it's like I've always told him, I go, dude, you need to be a dick. You know, be an asshole. Be mean. Stop being nice. If that's what the Joe we get when he's a dick, right? Or when he's mad. Dude, it's going to be amazing next year.
Yeah, it sounds like I did a lot of talking to people in his camp, and it sounds like, yes, the Nick thing helped, but really what it was is – as simple as it is, he has structure now. Like, he didn't really have structure. Like, now he's like, Nick says, hey, you're doing 230s, and that's, you're not bailing out.
With a bunch of little kids.
Yeah. You're doing 230s, and this is what you need to work on, and telling him that, and then also telling him, hey, you can be here. Like, we've known Joe for a long time. He had no self-confidence, mm-hmm. right? Especially amateur. And so now it's like the complete opposite. He knows he belongs up there, right?
Mm-hmm. First person he goes and talks to after the race is always to Mitch, straight there.
Yep.
And that's cool because you think like, what was it, earlier even this season, oh, I don't talk to Mitch at all.
Yeah.
So cool to see that get better and better.
He's getting a lot better with testing too. He knows what he wants. Even if he's like not afraid to try stuff now. Like gotcha. During the week, he's like, hey, let's try this, let's try that. So. Yeah, I'm excited for him for next year for sure.
Yeah, I'm curious to see how he rebounds in Supercross. Mm-hmm. This year was tough on him. You know, he was definitely the one coming in that everyone was like, hey, like Joe's riding really good. He's blazing fast as a test track. I mean, we've seen him a lot at State Fair riding. Like his whoop speed and everything. So I'm curious to see what coast he ends up on, what coast Jett ends up on. I think he's definitely going to be one of the guys if he comes in and rides like he knows he can.
Well, I know that the thing with Supercross this year, his whole approach with the trainer he was with was more intensity, more hang it out. Stop riding so smooth and within your means. Let's hang it out. And he said, hung it out a little too far.
Not yeah.
Crash so much. But, I mean, dude, great learning year for him still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What else? 250 class.
We just had Justin Cooper here, so it was fun to talk to him. He did really well. Another hot and cold day there for a little bit, but then made it.
Yeah,
count
well, did,
when it
in the show, did he talk about how bad he's been struggling with his breathing because
yep.
of COVID?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah.
So I wanted to talk a little bit about Moose Can, right? So yeah. He hasn't been on the bike as much as I thought he was. I mean, I thought he
5 days.
5 days. And then, you know, he's been on vacation. He, you know, hasn't been doing the proper training, but I feel like he hung in there pretty good.
I think if he didn't get a bad start in the second moto, it would have been a lot different. Because look how well he did in the first moto.
I feel like I think it was just average, right? It's not overwhelming. It's not underwhelming. I was seeing him anywhere from like 4 to 8, and was he 5.9? So I mean, he was there, mm-hmm. right?
The going off by the finish line, I think that was like the biggest mistake of the whole day. And look how much that cost him.
Yeah, he was riding the shit out of that little bike,
mm-hmm. dude. Yeah. Right? It was so fun to watch.
Dude,
so
he was hard on the clutch too. Like we were up there, like in the switchback by the start area, and you hear him coming around, just like it sounded like Don going through the corner. Yeah. It's freaking crazy.
Yeah, he was badass. And yeah. He's got more time before of Nations.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So pro debut for Chance Hymus.
Yeah.
Did well. I liked the Deegan Hymus battle that was there for a minute. That
yeah,
was
it was good. Yeah, I think he would have been a little bit better if he had got a start in that first moto. He was pretty buried, right? So I think the heat and everything got away from him. It's so weird, right? Because I was talking to Weimer. He's like, I don't understand how he can go out for an hour and a half wide open and then transition to like a dirt bike race where it's only 25+2 like it was this mm-hmm. past weekend, or 30+2 and like him get a bit winded. But it's totally different, right? Like, I don't know. You're racing against guys. You're taking roost, all this stuff. But, yeah, I think he rebounded that second moto and did super well. Mm-hmm. I mean,
I talked to Chance on Friday, and he's like, well, now I'm on the bike. I'm on the Honda bike now. Suspension, engine, everything. And he's like, I feel much, much better on this. And he's like, I went and did that that NGPC.
Yeah.
And he's like, I did that after Loretta's. And he was like, that was the perfect way to clear my head after everything. Like, after how bad Loretta's went, and I just couldn't get comfortable, and I was never comfortable all summer. He's like, that was the best thing I needed than to do the combine, than to do this. And he's like, however tomorrow goes, I already know I'm pretty good. And then now he's going to move down to Florida, and he'll be in the 83 compound program, and it's on mm-hmm. now for him.
Yep.
But yeah, so that'll be fun to follow him. Dude, Deegan did great. To watch him ride his home track,
I gotta
to
say, he like really impressed me because
like in qualifying,
he was one
good.
Of the mm-hmm. like few guys I saw just searching for, especially when he was behind Hymus. Like mm-hmm. he was taking outside lines that no one was taking all day, just ripping, going everywhere Hymus wasn't going. It was pretty cool to watch.
And to see like these young kids, how fit they are, they actually are. I mean, Deegan, like, he didn't go backwards the whole day. His lap times, you watch either at Ironman, you know, even that second moto or both motos at Paula, like, his lap time, same, yeah. same, same, same. Like, every lap. I thought that's cool.
Especially
know?
Deegan, because some reason we couldn't get the poor kid nice jerseys.
Just the iron-ons.
Before, just the hot-ass iron on the back. Yeah. Oh, that had to suck.
Did you see his butt patch?
Uh-uh.
It said, please be patient, student rider.
Yeah, you said that, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, Dahmer and I were talking last night, and when you talk about these kids, and you see how small some of them are, mm-hmm. like, they're not AC small when AC came in, but Deegan's a smaller kid. Chance is just an average, like, 17, 18-year-old. And then you see where Jett's at right now, being just now, you know, into adulthood, early adulthood, and you know how much he's got to bulk up before he gets on the 450. Mm-hmm. Even these young kids still have a lot of maturity that they got to go through. And it's interesting to see how they're going to do it. You see with Jett, even before he gets to the 450, we were talking last night, like, for Osho, this has got to be the ultimate, like, $6 billion man. Like, how can we make him better than he's ever been?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Johnny looked pretty happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I want to talk a little bit about Mumford, too, because, dude, I mean, he was up there, both motos. I think he shot his wad a little bit too early in the second moto. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, dude, first moto, top 10, all that. He went backwards a little bit in the second moto, but, man, he was up there. I mean, he was the only Suzuki up there. You know, I mean, I feel like that says something. And he was racing all day against some of the good guys. I mean, he was right there in a heated battle with, you know, Thrasher, you know, Hampshire, all of those guys. I mean, he was one. He was the only non-factory rider in the top 10. Yeah.
Yeah.
Is he on that team next year?
Yep.
Yeah.
But the team's changing.
Possibly, yeah.
Manufacturers are changing, or manufacturers changing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ah. What color?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I've heard rumors, but I can't say for sure. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I hear both Suzuki teams might be. I mean, that's
The other one's probably not.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. That's not good. But
for Brandon.
No, I mean, dude, that bike is good. Like, it's going to be hard to find guys that want to ride that bike. Yeah. I mean, you're going to have to pay them a little bit extra for them to ride that bike, I feel like, you know.
They tried. I mean, they tried to get the guy that was last most successful on it.
Yeah.
And that's a great-ass idea.
Yep. But, and I would think, too, if that comes along, then the support that they need would then step up.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
You know? Yeah.
It's funny, too, because that was, like, the one team where I was like, that could work. Like, with everything he's got going on, I could see them changing some stuff around to make
letting
that
him
work.
Have a Red Bull deal still. Yeah.
Let the Fox thing go.
No
air fork. Happen. Yeah.
No air fork.
No.
No.
Dude, remember the air fork broke at Glen Helen on him?
Yeah, and it just
stuck down.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so dude.
Wasn't that even the one with the counterbalancer on the bottom of it, too?
Yeah. Triple fail fork.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Triple fail fork.
Yeah.
We got to talk about the worm. Rodman showing up. What a championship bonus.
Right. Yeah. That was awesome.
So, was that all Lucas?
Yeah. So, he's rep by Wasserman.
Okay.
Rodman is. So, yeah. So, as we're watching the 250 Moto, Dahmer sends us his text, and he's like, Rodman's in the booth. And then there's a picture of it, and I'm like, what? But Kenny Bell had been hanging out with them all day?
Yeah. So I was actually over there at the Monster trailer, and then Kenny gets a text, and he gets from, like, the lady that does, like, the TV. She's like, hey, you with Rodman? He's like, yeah. He's over here, like, you know, in the deal. She's like, can we get him in the booth? He's like, I mean, I'll ask him, but I don't really know if, like, you know, he wants to. But, yeah. I mean,
I'm not his handler.
Yeah. I mean, Kenny Bell just walked in there. He's like, hey, dude, like, they want you on TV. Like, what's up? Like, you trying to do this? You trying to just chill? Like, you know, what's going on? So, yeah, Kenny Bell, he was like the middleman right there. I mean, of all people, right? I mean, Kenny Bell.
Best conduit that there could be, though, too.
Yeah, 100%. Like, I mean, if anybody's going to talk to Dennis Rodman, like, it's got to be Kenny Bell, the dude with the long, luscious hair, you know.
What if this is, like, what gets Kenny out of a monster job, and now he's just Rodman's assistant full-time?
Yeah, I mean, it's big baller all of a sudden.
I mean, it's badass. It might be. I mean, so who knows? I mean, Kenny Bell just right there, just doing it, right? I mean, Dennis Rodman.
Hilarious. Dude, I couldn't believe it.
Like, he even came to the Monster after party. Yeah, he was there. He was there, like,
dude, everybody
out.
Has pictures of him at the after party.
I know, right? Yeah. So, I walked up to him. I'm like, yo, Dennis, like, trying to do a shot? You know, trying to get a shot going, you know? He's like, yeah, bro, let's do it.
What'd he do?
Took the shot.
No, what shot?
Oh, it was tequila.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was good, yeah.
Apparently,
he didn't flinch. Like, he
was at Doc G's one year when I was there.
He thought it was
water. Apparently, yeah, apparently he knows everybody in moto. Yeah. And, like, he's ridden motorcycles forever and all that stuff. Like, he's talked about that in documentaries and everything. But, like, he had a bar in Huntington or in Newport or something like that for some time. And everybody, like, any 90 motocrosser knows Rodman.
Wow.
Holy shit.
Yeah, I didn't know that was such a big deal that he was there.
Was it Cassidy's?
I've seen him at Doc G's. You know? So, yeah.
There were a couple people that I was talking to at the end of the day, and they all had, like, Rodman stories from back in the day, and I'm like, of course you people would. Of course you guys would be the ones that have these stories, yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, the whole day on Saturday, it was like Rodman, and then you had Hollywood just, like, right there. Uh-huh. You know, Spikovic, and he's like, oh, yeah.
Was he going like this?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, what else?
Well, okay, so I was telling you guys before this got going, Rodman was everywhere in motorcycling this weekend. We were so pumped to have him, but then Pecco Bagnaia, that won the MotoGP race, had a Rodman helmet, too. Like painted after his hair, but the MotoGP people were not as happy about the Rodman influence this weekend. They think he's like a serial abuser and all this stuff, so they were very unhappy.
Yeah, and then we're over here just like raising the roof, Rodman. Yeah,
let's do it. What was it like in Vegas that weekend?
Yeah,
yeah. When did Michael come pull you out of the bed?
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it's totally different dynamic for the dirt bike guys, right?
It totally.
So
is.
Where was the negativity coming from over there? Was it on? Did they have a Vital MX forum?
No, it was like one journalist in particular. Like, I guess nobody had asked this rider, like, in a PR circle, because we don't think about, like, oh, yeah, if you're going to do these custom painted helmets, whatever. Nobody had, like, alleged it to him. But this guy's also had kind of a checkered year. He got a DUI on his break in Ibiza.
Nice.
And they just kind of let that go, you know? Yeah. But it happens, you know. Yeah. You got to think about all the partying that, like, motorcycle racers have been doing forever. It's just, it is what it is. So it's weird to see so many people get up in arms about it now, you know, but whatever.
It's just a different.
It's
different,
the time of day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see all the people?
And then we have Joe over here with a happy ending.
Yeah.
Dude, like if you watch MotoGP, they want to get rid of the grid girls, like the umbrella girls so bad. And then we're like, monster, let's double down.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
More girls.
More girls. Yeah. New talent.
Yeah.
Ripping.
Dirt Shark, let's get a video for like 10 minutes on YouTube of chicks just shaking
just
their
a
ass.
Chick. Yeah, just yeah. A chick.
Good video.
It's a good video.
I saw Ash a couple weeks after that. I'm like, hey, you crushed that. Like, for what that was and how well you did it and all the places you shot, that thing was sick. And he's like, thanks.
Hey, thanks, man.
Thanks a ton.
Did you guys see Nico Izzy?
I did, yeah.
Did you see how many people were like, yeah, Nico? Like,
yeah.
People were stoked for him.
I saw him cheering on, like, a certain privateer team, but only them, basically.
Oh. Heck, yeah. That's sick.
Yeah, so he's on that team next year, right?
Well, oh, he is.
Yeah, he's got a contract, yeah.
Wow,
yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
He's already ready to come back.
It's very fitting, we'll say that.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I saw the shirt, yeah. Yeah. Well, we got the Nations
else?
Coming up.
Yeah,
that'll be the next big thing.
Yeah,
and I would
yeah,
think
2 weeks away, 3 weeks away, not two.
Well, like what we said earlier, watching Chase and Eli come off after that, and then they shook hands, but both of them were like, "Yeah, this is great. Whatever, we're gonna go to the Nations now." So like, they're already looking past whatever this whole summer was.
Yeah.
That and then.
Well,
Eli,
the rivalry was never bitter.
No, dude.
No,
it was very respectful.
This is like watching. Like boxers, like for heavyweight titles, one after another, and they'll just keep linking up and they'll keep doing it again, and you'll see them go at it again. But yeah, like even just how mutual respectful they were towards each other, and then both said, like, hey, the next goal is this. Eli said Chase is the next big 450 guy. They're keyed up for donations. But then a lot of people are doing good right now. Tom Vial won MX2 championship last weekend or yesterday. He won't be riding for Team France as of right now unless something changes. Like if Marvin has to jump up, if Dylan can't race because of his back. But I don't know what they'll do. But like Seaver is coming here to ride. Mitch Evans is coming here to ride. So people are starting to prep pretty soon. So it little by little is getting ready to get intense.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Would you think that they would be flying to California to get ready or
Florida?
Florida. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Because Seaver and Evans are really tight with the Lawrence brothers, so they'll just be at 83.
Okay.
So that'll be cool. But yeah, like it's coming.
It's
gonna
be crazy for them to like come over. Like, wait, you guys ride at this badass place every day? Like,
yeah.
Wait, what? Because see the guys in Europe riding like the fucking rock quarries and shit.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's so much different.
Dude, but Red Butt.
I know.
I have I have a whole different appreciation for that now. I mean, obviously it was.
Yeah.
It was puss when we wrote it.
It was puss. Puss.
But yeah, I'm looking back. I'm looking forward to going back.
Yeah, I'm extremely jealous.
Oh, hey, I heard you guys have another like all-time facility you might get to ride at for a bike intro.
For the Yamaha?
Yeah.
Ulrich wouldn't tell me what he's talking about.
Oh, okay.
Do you know?
Uh-huh.
What did he say?
Down south.
Down south. What?
Yeah.
What's down south? South of the border?
No. Star.
Goat?
Oh.
That's what I heard.
Wow. I mean, that would make sense, I guess.
That's, like, supposed to be the Yamaha, like, that, like, four-star to buy that. That was important for them to get it. But yeah, because Yamaha is in Atlanta, that's, like, the place now. We have this private facility that we can do any photo shoots, and we don't have to worry about renting anything out or keeping people off. Yep.
Wow. See, okay, so, like, we had the KX250 intro last week. Cowie rented Paris. And Shimoda, Hammaker, McAdoo, DeFrancisco, Anderson, all there, right? I want to know if it was like Cowie said, hey, we've got this place rented anyway. You guys want to ride because there's no place to ride during the week? Come
ride.
That's
probably what it was, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right? But if it was like, hey, come out and ride, and the journalists will be so stoked to share the track with you. That's not the fucking case.
Dude, I hope it wasn't that.
Like, I mean, I wasn't going to ride anyway because it was so hot, and I had, what did I have? Oh, I had a dentist appointment or something. But anyway, yeah. So I was shooting photos and stuff, but it was just like, dude, I felt sorry for, like, some of the.
Right?
Like, there were some test riders out there that straight up sucked, right? Yeah. And it's like. Dude, what business does that guy have on the track at the same time as Joe Shimoda or Jason Anderson, right?
Yeah.
And then it's like, think about, like, if you're the test rider that falls down on the landing of a jump and takes out one of the top
guys. I mean,
we
had test riders that weren't jumping things. Like, they were.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, it was.
That'd be me.
Well, it's, yeah. I really hope it's just because we're in a pretty shitty situation in California
right
now.
Right?
There's
yeah.
no tracks to fucking ride.
But on those lines. We're going to Star headquarters to ride this bike. I don't want to ride at the same time Eli's riding.
I would you see those big-ass jumps there, too?
Yeah, dude. I've been there. I don't want.
I'll go to the rut check.
Yeah, I think the worst thing you need to worry about is if Jeannie's going to, like, scream
at
you.
Oh,
make
yeah.
you do burpees or something. They should do that for the full effect.
Oh, yeah. Ah, Jesus. That's pressure, man.
Right?
Yeah. But, yeah.
Oh, Rich, we'll just take it at Glen Helen.
Yeah. Give us a Glen Helen. We'll go ride Area 51 after. Okay. So, ARay, good luck with the surgery.
Thank you.
Anton, safe flight home.
Have fun on your holiday.
Yeah, you guys, peace out. You're doing the podcast Monday without me.
We are? Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna have to figure out a time. Might have to do it a little bit early.
All right.
That's cool with me.
I mean, I'm not calling in from Italy.
We'll just talk about.
I won't have anything to talk about.
I'm going to be back in Kentucky.
Oh.
We'll just talk about.
Pound Town KY.
Whatever.
There'll be we'll come up with something. Yeah. Let's brainstorm ideas this week.
Yeah.
For real. Yeah.
All right. Guys, thanks for listening as always, and we'll talk to you next week. Or they will, not me. Peace out, guys.
Since 1991, ProTaper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, ProTaper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more.